5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Hello, 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 and welcome. Welcome back to Space Engineers on the Xbox, on the Series X. And this is a quick tutorial on some more aspects of your inventory management system. You might recognize this little base. This is the original base moved over here from that mountain there that I started with almost 2 years ago on the Xbox. Nothing remains of my original PC saves on my Space Engineers, sadly, on the PC. Anyway, I'm on the Xbox now, and this little base serves our purpose. So what are we looking at? Well, we're looking at my little cargo ship here and my conveyor sorter. You'll see this in action in the conveyor sorter tutorial. I've already gone through that ages ago, but this one is pulling everything that it can possibly off this little ship, all whitelisted, and it'll pull it through the system and dump it into this cargo box. Now, recently somebody mentioned that they wanted to move from one grid to another, from their headquarters large grid base to their mobile small grid base, and they didn't want to use the tedious process of stuffing everything into their inventory and then carrying it all the way across to put it into their ship or into their mobile base. So how can you get around that? Well, there's a few things you can do, and there's a few things you have to remember. In any system whatsoever, if you connect even a sorter like this into an external connector and tell it to pull things from your base into that connector, one of the issues you're going to have is that 9 times out of 10, the H2 generator off or on and your assemblers and so on will pull ingots and ice back into the system. A reactor will pull uranium back into the system. So those things are very tricky to get rid of automatically. But let's say that you wanted to get a bunch of stuff out of your assemblers onto a mobile base. Say you'd got a bunch of, I don't know, let's have a look what we've got in my inventory. Right, here we go. We're going to talk about filters in a minute. Make sure everything is set. So the large cargo container, and we're going to dump a metal grid in, set in there, some of that. Oh, we'll put that in. And put those motors in. If we put the ice in now, watch what happens to the ice in a moment. Notice ice has pulled across here into this anyway. If we take it out, ice. Here, it'll get shuffled into your O2 generators. Now, any spare ice will actually move into this system. Only the ice from the O2 generator won't move. So what I've got here is this conveyor sorter on out, and this conveyor sorter here is on drain all, and it's whitelisting ingots, ore, components, and ice. So, when we turn it on, it will pull things into that connector. And we can it's pulled a bunch of stuff across.
Good.
So that's a way you can move things out of your cargo boxes into another ship through a connector. Now, if you want that ship to automatically pull resources across, you may need to add a conveyor sorter into the connector system of that ship. So underneath where your connector's connected, there'd be a conveyor sorter on your ship side there, pulling things into your ship. But the issue there is that you can't pull them back through. It's a one-way system. Imagine lots of gears and small rollers pulling things through. They're not going to let you pull them back the other way. To do that, you need to just basically make an open system where anything that you want comes out of here onto another connector that's not linked into this system, or that's bypassing the conveyor sorter in some way. So you can see here, I've got my little ship. If I throw just some glass, the glass will get pulled into the base, and then automatically there's room for it. Nope. What's it pulled across? Everything is there. So hold on. The glass will be stored in the cargo container. So if I pull out from here all this stuff, notice the ice is being pulled across. There's the glass. Being pulled across through the system. Now, obviously, this is if you want to load up your mobile base with all those lovely components and so on. But if you just want to mess around with cargo containers, moving things from one place to another, let me take you to space. We're going to find my full build of the Sargasso. That's why, and we'll teleport. We'll see that we are now in space by the Sargasso. Flip us around. This is the rebuilt bridge using the new bridge window slopes, bridge window face, compared to, if you remember, its original bridge, which was flat. I quite like this rebuild. And what we've got on the Sargasso, apart from these, which are Monster King's Gemmon Mark 1s, brilliant thrusters, we have a connector, and that connector goes into the O2 system. And at the back of the ship, here, we have a connector. It's the main connector. That's where all the cargo gubbins goes. So if we go back on board the Sargasso, don't worry about the doors because they're on an automatic closing timer block system. We are aboard the Sargasso. And we have two refineries and some assemblers. So we can have a look at the inventory system on this So if we open up the inventory here on this refinery, you can see that we can put some ingots in if we want. Stock it up with the ones we've got. And then what we're going to do is we're going to use the filters to look deeper at this ship. So on the left hand side, let's say we want to move stuff from our refinery here into one of our cargo boxes. So we open up the filter by clicking in the left stick, and you'll see each time you click in the left stick, it flicks through a filter and it tells you character, ship or station, energy, current ship, storage inventories, system inventories. Now, system inventories includes things like refineries, assemblers. So if you filter to system inventories and then hide empty, you'll see the box that we want to use, which is the refinery. Then moving across using the left stick, not the D-pad, we then can go over here, find our cargo. There's the storage. So we'll ignore the beds. So we have large container storage 1 and 2. But let's say we want to put something into our main small cargo container 1. So with that highlight there, you'll see, using the left stick, lit up, push left on the left stick, and then press A on the inventory that you want. And the same if you want to move things back to your refinery. Don't come off that page, just move it to the right again. And you can easily transfer from one to the other. This also includes transferring things from a small grid base to a large grid, or large grid base to a small grid mobile base. As long as they're connected via a connector and you have your containers open and the system doesn't have any blocks like conveyor sorters, or you've not welded up a pipe, or the pipe's in the wrong place, make sure all your connections are green, you can move things through your system. So maybe we want to move things to a different storage container. So we can flick through. There's small cargo container main again. But let's say we want to move things to small cargo container main 2. So with that highlight there, back across with the left stick, use the D-pad to move to the end of the queue. And there you have it. And the same thing, come across with the left stick, like so. Oops. And use the D-pad to navigate here, just to get there. And then press again, and you can move it between your boxes. And by using these filters and filtering empty things and so on, you can get access to all of your connected inventories on both screens and move things seamlessly between them without having to use your character's inventory. And trust me, it makes things a lot simpler when you're moving things from one ship to another. If you had two Sargassos docked together between two connectors, you could move things between these two Sargasso cargo inventories, as I said, as long as there aren't any conveyor sorters or any problems in the conveyor system itself. And that really is all you need to know about moving things, either automatically using sorters or manually, if you just want to take that little bit of extra time and ensure things are done correctly. That's it. That's all for this particular video. I don't want it to run overly long. Just one more thing to say. Check the link in the description of this video, Marek Rosa, CEO of Keen, put up a very interesting post about the community side of space engineers, including something called the community update that's coming free. Lots of new blocks, rounded windows. I believe this is with the help of modders, as Keen is very keen, pardon the pun, to bring modders into the fold even more. You may remember way, way, way back, there was no fighter cockpit. If you check that blog post, you'll see that Marek gave a shout out to the modder responsible for the fighter cockpit, and that became part of Space Engineers. Some of the best things in Space Engineers have been done by the modding community, and I would like to take a moment to say a big, huge thank you to the modders and the scripters. Even though I play solo, I can't really use scripts. It would be nice if Keen could somehow put a pack of the best vanilla scripts, the ones that we know work really well, into the game as part of the solo experience, so we can play around with some of these things, like ISIS script that closes the doors automatically to save using timer blocks. Things like that would be great. Or the expanded turret controller script for the new block that sounds very interesting. I wouldn't mind seeing that in action on a solo or hosted multiplayer game. Anyway, that's it for me. Thank you very much for watching. Thank you once again for subscribing. We are closing in on 2 years of Xbox related only content for Space Engineers on this channel. There will be a new channel intro because I want to make it a little more generic, because I don't really want to completely do the intro every year as I move one more year into doing Space Engineer stuff. Check out that link though to Marek's blog. I'll catch you in the next one. Have fun, stay safe, take care, enjoy the game. Keen are working very hard on fixing the bugs and issues that came out with Warfare. Until then, bye for now.